While Romney is booed, Utah GOP fails to censure him for Trump impeachment vote. And see, that's the big headline that many conservative publications are running with, although not all. Some are a little bit under. There's nuanced conservatives and less nuanced conservatives. The biggest voices are almost always not the nuanced ones. They're the ones throwing sugar and fire. They're sugar and fire conservatives. They'll mostly focus on the Utah GOP booing Mitt Romney. This is, I remember a few years ago, I used to always see this for some reason, Judge Jeanine Pirro, of all people. Judge Jeanine Pirro was constantly, this was when Obama was still president, and she was constantly destroying and wrecking. And also I saw Judge Napolitano, another judge, so all constantly destroying and ending careers. And you saw in some of the hearings, you saw Trey Gowdy there constantly destroying and ending careers, none of which were ever destroyed or ended. And no real power was shifted in any way, shape, or form. This is kind of how I'm viewing this. This is the Mitt Romney went before the people, and the people booed, but the people and their real masters made sure that Romney didn't suffer any real consequences. You got the booing, and everybody got to feel good about themselves. It's kind of a false victory, if you will. And that's what Jeanine Pirro with her false victories, where she ended Obama with her latest SmackDown rant that she used to have. I don't know if she still does those things. And Trey Gowdy in these congressional hearings laying the SmackDown, but nothing really happening. There's no significant investigations, no arrests, nothing like that. So I cover this because it's important in some sense, in that it is indicative that the people are tired of eating cake, but it's also indicative that the people providing the cake, they haven't gotten the message, or they just don't care. And in this case, the leadership of the Utah GOP, they just don't care. They don't care because they are the Washington Generals team playing the Harlem Globetrotters. And there's a script, and they know they're supposed to lose, and they make sure they lose. And they try just hard enough, like they'll let you boo, and they'll let Jeanine Pirro give the SmackDown and Trey Gowdy give his SmackDowns. But there's never going to be any significant victory. Pay attention to what happened in Canada when the Conservatives took power under Stephen, whatever his last name, I can't remember, Stephen Harper. When the Conservatives came to power, they should have immediately ended the human rights panels. But they didn't. They didn't significantly end any real Democrat, quote-unquote liberal power, nor did the Republicans when they had the House and the Senate and Trump. They didn't end any of the real centers of power that their alleged enemies actually had. They didn't move. Trump could have moved. He only started at the very end throwing out stuff with this, we're going to end critical race theory in schools. But in the beginning of his term, when he could have done a lot more, he brought in the same RNC that were as feckless as they always have been. He brought those people into his cabinet, and he proceeded to do nothing of real substance to fundamentally end their power, to call into question how the, quote, media is being treated. If you want the power and if you want the protection, the Bill of Rights protection of a free press, then you have to be a free press. And they're not a free press. They're agitprop. They are political organizations, and they should be treated as political organizations. When they work so diligently for one party over another, that should be treated as campaign contributions. Nothing of substance was ever done because, well, I don't know necessarily that I'll say that Trump was a team member of the Washington Generals, but I will say that I think that Trump didn't recognize the game that was really being played. I don't think that he really realized that he was walking into totally fake wrestling. Well, you know, professional, not all, well, Olympic wrestling is real, but so fake wrestling. Nothing wrong with fake wrestling. Fake wrestling, especially because now we know. But fake wrestling, that's a lot of skill to do what they do. That's theater. That's great theater for people that like that stuff. I'm not necessarily into it, but I totally respect fake wrestling as far as an athletic, dramatic event that requires high skill. So if you're a wrestling fan, I'm not busting on you. God bless you. So I read this story, and again, it's from The Blaze here. Trump critic Mitt Romney booed, heckled at Utah Republican event. Right, heckled, boisterously booed on Saturday when he took to the stage. Romney, one of the most prominent Republican critics of former President Donald Trump, whatever. I don't care. The other headlines, bid to censure Mitt Romney for Trump impeachment vote fails. This is from the Times of India. Collins defends Romney and Cheney amid GOP attacks over impeachment vote. And that's from Talking Points Memo. They revel in this. So there you go. The Republican Party is the Washington General's party. And I do believe, and this is speaking for me, I don't represent the Freedomist totally when I say this, but as for me, and I think I'm aligned within the diversity of what the Freedomist is, Christians operating in the civic, until we human beings who fundamentally reject anti-Americanism, and I'm going to cloak that only in terms of if you're against the Bill of Rights, you're not an American. If your ideology points you away from free speech, from the right to bear arms, you're not an American. You shouldn't be considered American. Maybe you're an American citizen. You should be treated as an American citizen, but you shouldn't be treated as an American, a people, a nation whose God is the Lord. That's what I say. Although you can be an atheist and still adopt the Bill of Rights, and I'm cool with calling you an American too. So unless and until something rises that is totally free from what the Republican Party is and totally free from the dependence that the Republican Party has, and the Republican Party is just as dependent on the corporate state nationalist as the Democrat Party is, even though the corporate state nationalists do favor the Democrats, but they throw the GOP a little bit of a bone because the GOP, again, that's the Washington Generals team. The Washington Generals don't get paid as much as the Harlem Globetrotters, but they do still get paid to do their fake sports. There you go.